When adversities knock your door, how do you respond? Greetings to you in the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to the 28th day of a journey from wilderness to Calvary. As we are journeying to this great mystery, to celebrate the great mystery of a resurrection of the Lord, we have almost completed 27 days and entering into the 28th day. My dear brothers and sisters, when adversaries knock at our door, how do we respond? There was a young girl who was feeling miserable about her life because of the trials, because of the pressures that she's undergoing in her education as well as in the work field. She went to her dad and said, "Dad, I'm feeling so miserable in my life because one after the other, the troubles, the problems are mounting up." And the father said, well, he took her to the kitchen and he took the eggs and then he took the potatoes, he took the coffee powder and he kept three pots in which he put all these three and made them boil. After boiling, he removed these three pots and removed the potatoes, the coffee, and also the eggs. And he asked his daughter, "What do you see here?" The daughter said, "I see the potatoes, eggs, and the coffee." "Well, you touch all these three and tell me, how do you feel?" This girl, young girl, touched the potatoes and she saw it was very soft. And she has touched the eggs, became very hard. And then the coffee was smelling so tasty. The father said, "Well, the water was the same, which was boiling. But three different things took different shapes. Like the potatoes became very soft, the eggs became hard, and the coffee has become tasty." And he told his daughter, "Our life becomes like that. Problems are same for everyone. How we mold ourselves into. Either these problems are making you very hard like the eggs, or soft like the potato, or more tastier than the coffee." My dear brothers and sisters, when adversaries knock our door, how do we respond? In the first reading today, we hear the story or life incident of Jeremiah, who was constantly being targeted by the people. And the people were torturing him, especially the priest, the temple priest, and the religious leaders, and much more than that, his own people, where he went and prophesied. And Jeremiah prays to God, "Lord, the adversaries are increasing around me. The problems are surrounding me." And he says, "Lord, take care, because I surrender myself to you. Because I have given myself to you. You have called me. And then you have placed me in this mission. But look out these people who are torturing me." My dear brothers and sisters, he takes the strength, courage from the Lord, depending on God. My dear brothers and sisters, notice, every adversary that comes to us, either it makes us strong or it makes us weak or it makes us defeated. Only three things can happen. If your mind is strong, you take every problem as a challenge. If your mind is weak, you take every problem as another problem. If your mind is balanced, you will see the problem as a challenge. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, as we are in the season of Lent, no doubt, the problems, the adversaries surround us. But how do we respond? How do we respond to the situation? Either we take that experience, that problem, that will make me strong to face another trial, or do I become weak like the potato, which can be crushed still more, and deep down within my heart I go down, or my life becomes much more tastier like the coffee, which will be useful for others. How do we respond? If you like this small piece of reflection, kindly share, like, and do not forget to contribute for the promotion of this Liturgy TV. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.